ओके हेलो फ्रेंड्स, अगेन वी आर बैक हियर विद द न्यू वन वीडियो दैट इज सिंटैक्स डायरेक्टेड ट्रांसलेशन SDT, विच विल बी एक्सप्लेन विद द एग्जाम्पल विच इज रिलेटेड टॉपिक टू द सिमेंटिक एनालिसिस फेज. एज वी हैव सीन प्रीवियसली सिंटैक्स एनालिसिस फेज एंड इट इज आउट इट्स आउटपुट इज नथिंग बट द ऑफ दिस फेज इज नथिंग बट द पार्स ट्री. वी हैव सीन नंबर ऑफ पार्सिंग टेक्निक्स. पार्स ट्री इज ऑल्सो नोन एज अ सिंटैक्स ट्री. ओके, इट इज अ प्लेन्ट पार्स ट्री. इट इज नॉट हैविंग एडिशनल इन्फॉर्मेशन. दैट इज द प्लेन पार्स ट्री. मीन्स वॉट? सपोज कंसिडर इफ यू बाय सम और यू बॉट सम मशीन एंड इट इज हैविंग अ मिसिंग मैनुअल. यू डोंट हैव मैनुअल विथ यू. सो इज इट एनी मीनिंगफुल और हाउ टू यूज दैट? इज देयर एनी इन्फॉर्मेशन रिलेटेड अवेलेबल विथ दैट मशीन? नो, देन इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल हाउ टू यूज दैट मशीन. So manual is an important. So that's way or same concept will be here. That is, parse tree is an input to semantic analysis, and it will give you semantically verified parse tree as an output. So you can say grammar plus semantic rule is nothing but syntax directed translation or syntax SDT. So here you can see a grammar, as we are working with this grammar only in previous video, and these are nothing but your semantic rules. Means what does this particular syntax is meaning? That is, eval is equal to eval plus tval, then eval is equal to tval. Means what? E is having two production rule, e plus t and e tends to t, these two. So that's why meaning of or semantic rules for that particular grammar is available in this video. And in this video we'll see what is SDT, how it works, what is the need of SDT. That is nothing but all these important things we'll discuss, because semantic analysis is important in parse tree. If we generated parse tree but we don't have any information regarding that parse tree, then it is meaningless and we cannot work further on that parse tree. That's why semantic analysis is important phase, you can say, and grammar is added with the some semantic rules to get the syntax directed translation. That is known as SDT. Okay, so in this video only we'll see that one simple example. As you can see, E plus T is a simple production rule for this grammar. Action is defined, but when to perform this action and how to perform? So it will start from your root node left to right side, and as you go like here, you will get the first non-terminal, that is the value having 5, suppose, and afterwards then there is a operator again t, suppose value is having 10, then you have to perform the addition of them, that is 5 plus 3, and whatever the result will be there, that will be written to your root node. Means from starting from root to your further variable or non-variable values, and that will be processed, and again you are returning to your root node. That is nothing but your grammar, or these actions will be defined by the syntax directed translation. Afterwards, as you can see, some of the rules or this grammar, you are by considering this grammar, and these are the semantic rules we are going to use. This is the example where we have to evaluate the one expression, 1 plus 2 into 3. Okay, 1 plus 2 into 3. So what we have to do is, starting from root node, it is not having now result. Afterwards, what is e tends to? E tends to e plus t, that is the first production rule. Okay, afterwards what is the e plus t? E plus t, so from e there are three edges, e plus and t. Afterwards we are having first value for that e, eval is nothing but 1. In our expression, value 1 is given, that's why 1 here. After that, e tends to t. In grammar you can see e tends to t also, so t val is also 1. Then t tends to f, so that's why t val is nothing but producing f. Afterwards f is nothing but your id, that is lex val, finally value, that is 1. Afterwards means you are going to assign one by one these values, and this plus operator, then this t. After T, you can see here T into F. T into F means what? There are again three edges from this T. T into F. So you will go downside and T will extend F, F will extend ID, and second value is nothing but 2. That will be assigned to this F as well as this T. Again, this is the operator and F. This is F. F tends to ID. It's the third one value, that is 3. And that will be assigned to F. So, we'll going to what is the operation T val into F val. So, what is the T value 2 and F val value 3. So, these 2 into 3 gives you 6. So, this 6 is assigned to this T val. This is nothing but your T val. Okay. And this 6 will be assigned, added, or this 6 will be added with E. E value is 1. So, finally you will get the root node value, that is 1 plus 6 is 7. In this way, it will be evaluated. Or in this way, all these product semantic rules are applied to this grammar and evaluated. So, these f dot val, t dot val, these are nothing but the attributes. And id dot lex val is nothing but this your terminal, and it will give you actual value of your expression. So that terminal will give you value, lex val. It is referred as a lex val. And finally you will get the value at root node itself. From root node you are going to start up to down, one by one, left to right you are going to traverse the tree, and finally answer will be getting at root node itself. I hope you are getting this concept, and it is very simple and easy to understand. And remember, that is grammar plus semantic rule is nothing but your SDT, that is syntax directed translation. And this is the simple description about that, and this is the simple example of SDT that you can solve easily in your examination. I hope this SDT basic concept you are known and you understood. Thank you. Thank you so much.